Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa salatu wa salam ala Sayyidina Muhammad al-Nabi al-Ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. First of all, the highest maqam is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Any association starting by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, or any work started by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, everything started by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah will continue it successfully and will accept it, Allah Almighty, as a sincere work done by his servant, because he started by the name of Allah Almighty, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And then we must thanks Allah Almighty by saying Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, because also it is a maqam, a spiritual maqam, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, maqam of thanks, maqam al-hamd. It is a maqam. Not only maqams mean maqams of dead ones whom they are buried in it, no. Every letter in the Holy Quran, it is a spiritual maqam. Every word in the Holy Quran is a spiritual maqam. Every ranks, every stage, every godly, divinely world is a maqam which Allah Almighty chose it and created it by be, so that it contains awliya, prophets, malaika. Through them Allah Almighty descend blessing to mankind, and on them Allah Almighty descending his mercies and good tidings, and from them then it descend on mankind, because they are the ones whom represent the divinely power of Allah Almighty between mankind, between all his creation, between all his servants, heavens, earths. They are supported by Allah Almighty through these big sealed of prophets, big awliya or big saints, malaika, so that Allah Almighty saying that rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu alaykum ahl al-bayt, my mercies and good tidings and the blessing on you ahlul bayt. Ahlul bayt means ahlul bayt, ahlul bayt of Rasulullah means these whom they are under the domes of Allah Almighty. Everyone has a maqam in heaven. Everyone has a maqam under the throne of Allah Almighty. Some of them, they have maqams in the throne of Allah Almighty. Some of them under the throne of Allah Almighty. Plenty of domes. And Allah Almighty saying, أَوْلِيَائِ تَحْتَ قِبَابِ لَا يَعْلَمُهُمْ غَيْرِ, my saints, my awliya, my sincere servants, includes prophets, and inheritance of prophets. They are under my domes. There are the real maqams. There are the spiritual maqam. There are no dead bodies, but all of them alive, from pre-eternal to eternal. Allah Almighty dressing them by godly life, by heavenly life, by Malakuti life, and they are the one whom Allah Almighty looking at them, and through them Allah Almighty look all over His creations. And for this, if we want to speak about Maqams, Maqams is something which is a very wide and cannot be limited, because once they ask a big awliya, a big saint called Sayyidina Abu Yazid al-Bastami, and he was named by Allah Almighty by the name of the Sultan of Nowars, Sultan al-Arifin. And they told him, tell us about the Maqam of Mountain of Qaf, where it is a big Maqam of Awliya, where Awliya meet. And plenty of big Awliya, they passed away and they are buried there. He said, this is a very nearby Maqam, so tiny. What about the Maqams of Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Sad? What about the Maqams of these mountains, Ha, Mim, Ain, Sin, Kaf? Every letter, starting every ayat by letters, and every letter is a Maqam, a divinely godly word by itself. In it, Allah Almighty crowded Malaika, Awliya, all types of Awliya, and also some prophets in every Maqam of this Maqam. There is 124,000 prophets, and Allah Almighty spread them all over 124,000 Maqam. And every Maqam is a divinely godly word of Allah Almighty, which is full with awliya whom they are inheriting from this awliya, from this prophet. And all of them, they are the one who represent as a khalif of Allah Almighty for the descending of good tidings, blessing and mercies, to reflect it on the children of Adam alayhi salam, on mankind, on creations, on heavens, on earths. And for this Allah Almighty saying, there is Maqams which will be totally concealed, vanished, when Allah Almighty will order Sayyidina Israfil, the Malaika angel Israfil, to blow the horn as a picture, as a figures, they will be no more existing. But their reality is still occurring, existing, because their reality never will be finished by the blown of the horn, because the realities of everything in the hand of Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty saying, فَسُبْحَانَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. The reality, the malakut of everything, it is in my hand, and you are going to return to me, where there I will dress you by these realities. No more this picture, no more this figure, but it will be dressed by reality in the second blown of the horn of Sayyidina Israfil alayhi salam. There is Maqams which never will be finished by the blown of the horn of Sayyidina Israfil alayhi salam. Never will be finished by the blown of Israfil alayhi salam. And Allah Almighty saying in the Holy Quran, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Allah Almighty is going to order to be Israfil to blow in the horn. And everyone is going to shocked. In heavens, in earths, no more existing, their picture, all, they will be totally, even heavens, paradises, earths will be totally finished, no more existing. Illa man sha Allah, Allah Almighty, saying illa, yani which mean, what is the meaning of illa istisna, which Allah Almighty saying, there is maqams which will not be harmed or shocked, illa man sha Allah. Yani Allah Almighty emphasizing that there is maqams that won't be harmed by the horn when it is going to be blown by Israfil alayhi salam, because they are already in the divine word of command of Allah Almighty, in the divine godly world related to Allah Almighty, which is over the throne. And over the throne, nothing will be harmed by the blowing of the horn. And these maqams, which Allah Almighty created it, its elements, these maqams are created from the elements of the heart of sealed of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the lives of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these whom they are in these maqams, they are not ordinary awliya or ordinary mankind, no. They are a special one whom Allah Almighty reached them in their life to reach to eternal life. And Allah Almighty then making them to ascend to His divinely presence and to remain up in these maqams, which are spiritual maqams. We say spiritual maqams because for us, these maqams over throne is something spirituality. But in reality, to Allah Almighty, they are ordinary maqams, but related to His divinely godly word of Allah Almighty. And there are the awliya. There are the realities of the prophets. There is the real kingdom of Allah Almighty, which Allah Almighty mentioning in the Holy Quran. O beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, praise your Allah, praise your God, who is the owner of this kingdom. Allah Almighty praising Himself by a kingdom. This kingdom of earth, of heavens, of galaxies is going to finish. It's going to come an end for it by the day of judgment. Everything will be finished. Allah Almighty is not going to praise Himself by Himself for something is going to be finished, no more existing. He's praising Himself by Himself for something is going to be continuing forever from pre-eternal to eternal. Where there Allah Almighty prepared cities built by lights of Allah Almighty, which one of these lights appear to 8 paradises or heavens, they will be totally burned, no more existing. They will go again to Adam, to unexistence. And these are maqams which the Sufi way, especially the Naqshbandi Sufi way, Maulana say, by practicing its the teaching of it in a proper way, by which means proper way, following the teaching, the real teaching of the one who is inheriting the divinely secret of prophecy from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who is dressed by and carrying the holy breath of Allah Almighty, which Allah Almighty blew by this breath into Adam, the soul. Allah blew it, the spirit, the soul, into Adam and keep it in him. This blowing kept. It was carried by 124,000 prophets as wakalatan, as deputies for the real one who is carrying this holy breath of Allah Almighty, sealed of Prophet Muhammad and Rasulullah. And then, after sealed of prophets, no more prophets to be deputies, then it come the maqams of awliya, to be the inheritance of this holy breath of Allah Almighty and the divine secret of prophecy from Rasulullah. The one who follow the by proper teaching, the one who is carrying these secrets and doing according to his will, until he will be a shadow for him, then he is allowed to enter into this maqams, spiritual maqams, over the throne, into the kingdom, godly kingdom, which is over maqams of malakut. It is the kingdom of Allah Almighty, which is in the maqam of the uniqueness of Allah Almighty, which cannot be descend less than this. But all of us, everyone wants quickly to be by one step reaching these maqams and to be related to these spiritualities of these big awliya, saints, prophets, with one step. And this cannot be, because since you are still worshipping gods, not saying yet La ilaha illallah, that there is no gods except Allah Almighty, since still every one of us is worshipping his ego by obeying the ego, worshipping his vanity, worshipping his desires, worshipping his love of dunya, his pleasures, his shaitan, money, love his physical life, and worshipping it by obeying it, and no one is listening to his soul. No one listening to his soul, or taking it as a guidance for him, to reach him to the divinely kingdom of Allah Almighty, the divinely presence of Allah Almighty. How by one step you want to reach these maqams? And for this, maqams of awliya or prophets, now you will see that all over the world it is planted by graves, over them a domes, a maqams, that there, this used to be an awliya or a saint. Finish. Why? There were so many, and now no one. Why before they used to be? And now no more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise be to Allah Almighty, Allah is finished. No more to dress anyone awliya. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now stopped. No more to give his secret to anyone. No. Allah Almighty, from ever to forever, no time for Allah Almighty, because He created time. The same for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La ilaha illallah, from pre-eternal, no one knows. To La ilaha illallah, forever, no end, no beginning, no ending, no starting, no border or a limit to be finished, no. And for this, Mawlana Sultanul Awliya, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim Qaddasa Allah Sirruhu, as a teaching, he wants to make in every one of us a maqam. He is building in everyone who obey him and follow properly his teaching, he wants to make from him a maqam, because Allah Almighty is addressing to anyone who is asking, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is addressing also his secret to anyone who is asking. But who is who asking? The one who is asking and referring himself to be in the way of the one who is inheriting the divinely secret of prophecy from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Sayyidina Ali, and the carrying the holy breath of Allah Almighty, which is blown in Adam alayhi salam by the soul, spirit inside of us, he will dress him by maqam. And as a sign that I am dressing you, if you are sincere, I am going to make a miracle, a sign to be every day with you. Be careful. You must notice it. Every day, every minute, every time is with you, but you must notice it. And so Mawlana was ordered from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to anyone who accept him and to follow the right way, the real way, leading to this kingdom of Allah Almighty, to the divinely presence of Allah Almighty, divinely presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to these spiritual maqams, which there are no dead ones inside, but all alive ones. All who represent, all of them represent the blessing, the mercies, the good tidings of Allah Almighty, the forgiveness, the shafa'ah, the intercession of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of them, very huge appearance that no one can dare to look at their faces. And so this sign, he put it on us, but we must notice it. And this sign is this turban. Look. It is the same as a grave. He built it as a grave. And for this, it is starting from here up, where the head, and then continuing down to the leg. This is the cover over the grave. I am going to dress it on the head of every one of you. And around it, I am going to put for you your coffins, so that in every moment, you are waiting to finish your human existence and to wrap it by this cover, by this coffin, throw it, and then you are able to be in one step in the divinely kingdom of world of command of Allah Almighty, where there is no panic by the blown of the horn or shock by the blown of the horn, where you are going to be forever alive by a godly life from Allah Almighty. And so everyone also now is dressed as a maqam. But we must notice it. We must take wisdom from it, take secrets from it, and must remember us when we are entering into any sin, to commit it, to repent quickly, not to remain in it. This for the one whom following the proper teaching. But the one whom they don't like to follow, and everyone is making a new school in the teaching of Grand Sheikh and Maulana Sheikh Nazim and all Grand Sheikhs, that this is what now people need, then you never are going to reach to any place, to any maqam. Even the ordinary maqams, which is for their bodies, you will stand facing it and nothing will come to you, because you are not switching on the light into your heart. Still switch off. How it will be switched on? Switch on by making the hand of the one who owns this power to switch it on. And this power of switching on is given only to Mawlana Sheikh Nazim to switch it on in all hearts. It's not given to anyone. Even Mawlana will appoint deputies, khalifs, anyone, but they are not authorized anyone to switch it on. Because switching on the heart means then this heart is going to be a maqam for Allah Almighty, maqam for Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, maqam for prophets, maqam for all awliya, spiritual maqam. It will shake the earths. It will shake heavens. Even it will shake the throne of Allah Almighty. And so he is not going to give it to anyone. All of them, they are as a ones to preach, to make da'wah, to preach, to bring people to the real way, to the real hunter. Who is the hunter? He's the one who had this power, inherited the divinely secret of prophecy and carrying the holy breath of Allah Almighty. He is hunting and making all these people to chase the hunted things and to bring it to the hunter. And even not allowed to eat from it, these dogs, or to put their teeth inside of it, as Allah Almighty saying in the Holy Quran. Only to bring it by their lips, not touching it and giving it to the hunter, to the real maqam, spiritual maqam, to the real khalif who represents Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and represent the divinely godly lights of Allah Almighty. If they are doing so, then this is correct teaching, proper teaching. If anyone saying or predicting or reforming or making a new school as his understanding and his style, then as if he is a dog putting his teeth inside the hunted one. And Allah Almighty saying, if a dog put his teeth in when he's chasing a hunted bird or anything by the hunter, if you put his teeth and put it inside, don't eat from it. Finish. It is poisoned. So it will be poisoned. And for this now you will see that this is something happening all over the history. Through all awliya, that they used to have plenty of deputies and khalifs and all, plenty. And for this you will see all the lines of these deputies and khalifs whom they tried to reform and make a school and to make a new teaching from the teaching of the Sheikh, all it is stopped. Never any one of them is continued. All stopped. And all the people were related to him, it is only in the hand of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah to make shafa'a for them. No one reached to anything. While the one who kept the correct and the proper teaching of the Shaykh, he reached to this highly divinely kingdom of Allah Almighty, which Allah Almighty make in it all spiritual maqams, all real maqams, all the maqams, which all these maqams you are seeing all over the earth, it is as a reflection, a picture of that domes which Allah Almighty praising, my awliya, my saints, under my domes in this room. No one knows them except me, Allah Almighty, praising himself. So jealous, Allah Almighty. He doesn't anyone to know them except him, because they are my sincere servants. Their sincerity make them to be all the time in my throne, under my domes, under my eyes. And these maqams all over the earth, they are symbols, pictures, shadows of these real maqams in the divine presence of Allah Almighty. And for this, the one who keep the proper and correct teaching, and he keep the proper and correct way, and he keep humbleness and take out from his heart all kind of jealousy, enmity, only he has good intention for everyone, even everyone harming him, even though he will have good intention, forgiving, and never following or worshipping the gods which he created it in himself and putting it as a statues beside the real God, Allah Almighty. Because Allah Almighty never will make the heart a real maqam for him and for his sealed of prophet until it will be cleaned and purified and sanctified from Allah Almighty, when you will totally take off from it all kinds of these gods and statues and no more anything in it except Allah. And for this, the awliya, they have a special dua, prayer. They say, O Allah Almighty, clean us and take from us the mud and the waste, the mud of this world, this ayah of this verse, La ilaha illallah, that there is no God except Allah Almighty. This is Kalimatul Tawheed. What is Tawheed in English?
Oneness.
Clean us from the mud of oneness. How in oneness there is mud? How in oneness there is mud? And the awliya, when they are starting in the smallest maqam of wilaya to biggest high maqam of wilaya, they will say, Oh Allah Almighty, clean us from the oneness, from the mud of oneness. Clean us from the mud of oneness. What is the meaning of this? Why they say, and so Maulana says, what is the mud of oneness? That to think or to say that there is no God except only one God, Allah Almighty, you are still in waste. You must have good intention and you have so strong faith and belief that really no God except Allah Almighty. Why to say it yet? Why to think that there is no God except Allah Almighty? You are not sure, and for this you are saying, and you are telling yourself, announcing, declaring for yourself, be careful, there is no God except Allah, no God except Allah, which means yet your ego, your nafs, yourself, not sure. And this is the mud of the oneness. Until you reach the Maqam of Big Wilaya, Mawlana say, where there they start to make zikr, how? No more la ilaha illallah, they say, illallah. Only Allah, only Allah, only Allah, you will inform yourself. Still you are in the mud of the oneness. Why to say only Allah? It is well known. It is only Allah. Why to tell yourself? Yet there is which mean doubts in yourself that you are informing it only Allah. Until you will reach to the maqam of uniqueness, then you will say there, Allah, 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 Allah. And this is the started of the Naqshbandi way by Allah, which is the end of all other Sufi ways, is the starting, the beginning on our way. Because they tried their best all in seclusion and years to make themselves cleaned from the mud of the oneness by saying La ilaha illallah until at their end to be big imams to reach to say Allah, Allah, where in our Naqshbandi Sufi way for the sake of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq addressed to dress all the ones who is in his way in the proper teaching. Not anyone saying Naqshbandi is Naqshbandi or Siddiqi, but in the proper teaching to start by Allah, for sure, no more to say we have doubts, we must inform ourselves that no God except Allah or only Allah, no, Allah, starting by the name of Allah Almighty. And then you are starting to ascend in the maqams of the uniqueness from one step to another step, from one step to another step, until you start to call zikr in your heart, no more the tongue to say it. Why to say the tongue to say it? To inform yourself, Allah, Allah. Also, this is a mud for the physical body. And so the heart starts to say, Allah, Allah, Allah. Until you reach a maqam in the uniqueness, in the highest maqam of the uniqueness, to make zikr by the pronoun of the referring to the absolute identity of Allah Almighty. Who? And Grand Sheikh said, and Mawlana, the line of our Grand Sheikh, they said, Mawlana, that the real sincere murids, if he come to me by sincerity, by one looking, I will reach him to make dhikr without who? Without these two letters, H and U, who, or WHO, who, or HU, who, without it. Because also he doesn't need for his heart. I will make him to reach a maqam as Allah Almighty making it a maqam in the day of judgment when Israfil alayhi salam blow the horn. And Allah will say, I am the Allah, I am the Sultan. Anyone to say anything? Anyone to call me? Anyone to say, to answer me? Anyone to reply me? Anyone reply? Until Allah Almighty himself by himself in your heart will call himself. Then no more you are making zikr, Allah Almighty making dhikr in your heart by himself to himself. And these are the highest maqams. These are maqams. These are the one now we are seeing all over the world. They try their best to read that maqams, spiritual maqams. And this is so easy in the hand of Maulana Shaykh, one Shaykh, if anyone follow the proper teaching, once this, they used to say it as a something that the one must follow the proper teaching of the Shaykh, not to miss it by following any reformers or schools whom they try to do new things in the teaching of the Shaykh, because nothing you are going to reach. And so this is a story from other Sufi ways that they said once a murid, he came to the Shaykh and he told them, I want to take initiation and I want to you to give me something to practice it. He said, yeah, I will give you something to practice it. What he used, he was thinking he's going now to give him to say Allah or La ilaha illallah, Allah according to the way, if it is Naqshbandi way, Allah, if it is other way, Sufi ways, La ilaha illallah, anything like this. And then he was so astonished and surprised, the Shaykh was telling him, do every day 1,500 times, onion, 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 go, finish. Without doubt, the Shaykh said so, and he was big awliya. He knows, and all people know that this is a big awliya. You want to test him. And so he was saying, as the Shaykh said, 40 days by saying onions, he reached to the highly maqams of wilay. Because he showed sincerity to the Shaykh, then the Shaykh was able to make shafa'a for him in the divine presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to accept him. Because how much you say Allah, 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 you will have good tidings for saying it. But it is coming by your ego. It's not, malaika not taking it up to Allah Almighty, still remaining in your books. If the Shaykh didn't make shafa'a in the divine presence of Rasulullah, and Rasulullah make for you shafa'a in the divine presence of Allah Almighty, never is going to reach to Allah Almighty. And this cannot be except by showing really sincerity to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to Allah Almighty, and to your Shaykh. Because who appointed this Shaykh? He appointed himself by himself. Allah Almighty appointed him. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, seed of prophet, appointing him. And for this Allah Almighty saying, I am appointing man, whom they are fulfilling their promises with me in the day of promise by totally pure sincerity, that nothing in their heart except love of Allah Almighty and love of Rasulullah. No gods worshipping beside me. No statues bowing to them beside me. رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. They fulfill by what they promise with me. And so some of them, my sealed of prophet, holy verses in the Holy Quran, some of them they passed away for eternal life. And some of them remain, and like this to Yawm al-Qiyamah, never stopping. But the one must ask for these maqams and related himself by sincerity to them, and he will reach to the spiritual maqams of them in the throne of Allah Almighty, under his domes of Allah Almighty. May Allah Almighty forgive us and bless us and mercy us and support us and make us sincere servants to him, sincere ummah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sincere murid to Unai Shaykh Nazim, to Grand Shaykh, to all Grand Shaykhs, and to Sahibu Zaman, Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. Ila sharafi al-Nabi Sayyidina Muhammad wa Adi wa Salih Hadrat wa Sadi wa Sadi wa Salaam Suddifi wa Al-Fatiha. Allah lina minahum.